Hello, everyone. For today's encouragement, I want to take you to 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 8. And if I were to title this, it would be, Get Along. Now, Peter tells all of you to get along, he says. Now, who are the all of yous? Well, he's already said, God's elect, strangers in the world, you have been chosen according to the foreknowledge of God, are all the all of yous that he's talking to. He's talking to the likes of us. And he tells us that we need to live in harmony with one another. A.W. Tozer has written, Has it ever occurred to you that 100 pianos all tuned to the same fork are automatically tuned to each other? They're of one accord by being tuned not to each other, but to another standard by which they must individually bow. So 100 worshipers meeting together, each one looking to Christ, are automatically tuned to each other. He says, when we are looking at each other and trying to tune to each other's needs, we will never make it. We are tuned to Christ. We then may be tuned to one another. All of you, Peter writes, live in harmony with one another. And then he follows that up with three things that we need to keep in mind in order for this to happen. The first, be sympathetic. The second, love as brothers. The third, be compassionate and humble. So let's take these one at a time. The first one, be sympathetic. When we are sympathetic, it is because we are aware of another's situations and the emotions that they have developed that are connected with that situation. And the reason we're more sympathetic and patient with a person like that is because we have actually got inside and we know their story. You and I can live in harmony with someone with whom we are sympathetic. We are sympathetic because we have heard their story and understood the baggage they carry, whether they are aware of it or not. I remember an old Elvis Presley song, Walk a Mile in My Shoes, and some of the lyrics go like this. If I could be you and you could be me for just 1 hour, if we could find a way to get inside each other's mind, if you could see through my eyes instead of your own ego, I believe you'd be surprised to see that you've been blind. Walk a mile in my shoes. Before you abuse, criticize, and accuse, then walk a mile in my shoes. So, having trouble living in harmony with one another? Well, let's start with being sympathetic, understanding where somebody else is coming from, what their hurts are, what their issues are very helpful for us to live in harmony with one another. Second thing he writes is love as brothers. Remember, the New Testament describes love as action that we do toward one another that is helpful to meet their needs. It is what we need to do if we are ever going to live in harmony with one another. You may not feel like doing something kind and generous and helpful for someone another. You might not feel like they deserve it. But we are told to love one another as brothers. Given the filial relationship we have with God and therefore with one another, we need to do what we need to do in order to get along. There's another song that is sung by a group called the Hollies. This goes back several years as well, but here's some of the lyrics. He ain't heavy, he's my brother. So on we go, his welfare is my concern. No burden is he to bear, we'll get there. For I know that he would not encumber me. He ain't heavy, he's my brother. We live in harmony with one another because we are sympathetic to the other's needs. And because we have determined to, in action, love them as brothers. The third thing he tells us to do if we're going to live in harmony with one another is to be humble. Pride says, my world, my plan, my ball, my rules, my needs, my opinions, my feelings. When pride is driving our lives, there is no way we will ever live in harmony with one another. But when we are humble, we listen to another. We understand one another. We respect one another. We recognize the value of another. We know they have talent, and we know if they're a believer, they have spiritual gifts. Pride does not recognize any of these things. Humility does. So right now, if you're not right with somebody else, you're not living in harmony with somebody else, then you have a responsibility. But Peter says, all of you, live in harmony with one another. Be sympathetic, love as brothers, be compassionate and humble. I read a story in the Star Telegram in Genoa, Texas, about a fire department that was setting fires to people's homes. In fact, they had set more than 40 fires When asked why, they said, well, we were bored. We wanted something to do. The reality is firefighters are not to be out setting fires, they're to be putting them out. Just the same as followers of Jesus are not to be out there creating problems with other people, but living in harmony with one another. All of you, live in harmony with one another. Be sympathetic, love as brothers, be compassionate and humble. My Lord, I encourage you to do that today. Amen.